All right, and welcome back to another Dark Souls. It is Mr. Chad here with Mr. Map Guy, which we are going to talk to in just a second after I parry. Yeah, there we go. Oh, that's so cool. I like this shield. It's amazing. All right, cool.
Oh.
So this guy right here, he is actually a cartographer. He has come to Dranglink because he doesn't remember, and he thinks that his purpose is to create maps. And inside of a mansion, inside of the Majula bonfire, he actually has a residence, and it actually has a map on the inside. And yes, okay, you'll be back in the Majula zone. And I'm only skipping this dialogue because I know you guys have already seen it from, you know, more popular channels, and that's fine. I mean, if you haven't and you actually really want to see this stuff, let me know. I can actually just stop and do all the dialogue, but I'm just going on the assumption that you guys have watched a more popular channel by now. But I don't know, maybe you come for me. That would be so nice. You guys are lovely, and I love you people. You're not even you people. You're my friends. You're like my friends. Let's backstab this fool. Yeah. Yeah. You're not going to shoot any more arrows anymore without a face. All right. Sweet. So there's also one other item I should go get, which is down here, I believe. Is there an item in there? I don't think there is. But let's drop down. And drop down here. Yep, whoa. Get a Titanite shard. Cool. They're actually pretty expensive to start with, but later on you can just buy them like candy, which is pretty nice. No. That's a lie. Never jump off into water. We know this from the Dark Souls routine. You basically sink like a rock in water, no matter how deep it is. So, yeah. Jerk move. But before we face the pursuer, who is actually up here, we're going to unlock a shortcut so we can immediately go back to here once we are dead. If we die, which I'm pretty sure we will. Okay. And this guy's going to huck some stuff at us. And we're just going to drink a doodad. We're gonna explode this stuff right here. Come on. Ow! Yeah, that hurt. That's okay. Because now we're at a bonfire again. Same bonfire as before. So, yeah, cool. Perfect. Now we have a shortcut unlocked. And I actually didn't know about the shortcut to begin with. I actually saw someone else playing it. And yeah, they unlocked the shortcut and I was super surprised. Because I didn't even think about that. Because later on, those will become more and more important. Those little explodey barrels. Nope, stop it. Stop it. Eat it. Yeah, there you go. Eat that. Okay, sweet. So now we are going to fight the pursuer. And before we fight said pursuer, I'm going to hit this guy off. There we go. So he is going to be dropped right here. So this guy here, this is actually supposed to be a boss, but I'm going to try and beat him right now. All right, put on the epic music. Oh, geez. That was a bad dodge on my part. Okay, you can't hit anything with that dude. Ah. Oh. So you can hit him a couple times when he's doing this. Oh, I keep dodging just a bit too early. Let's goad him into another hit. Okay, let's... Whoa, don't want to get hit by that. That is actually a very super powerful move. Okay, just get the old hit it. Oh. Ah, eat this. And actually, you can parry this guy, but I'm not good enough to do so. So, yeah, I'm not even going to try. Oh, come on, buddy. Ah, oh, and total miss. Take this. And this guy hunts down the souls of the undead in order to, like, alleviate his sins or something like that. There's a lot to do with sin in this game, I notice. There's even a boss related to sin, which is kind of cool. No, you don't. Stay away from me with your blue sword. Ouch. As you notice, you can actually still get hit, even when you are... Oh, jeez. Even when you are diving, that's a new feature to this game. Slice. Okay. Ouch. I need to get to a point. Oh, shit, and I died. Well, that was to be expected. And I wonder if he'll stick around. I don't know if he'll actually stick around here. But if he does, that'd be kind of interesting. Because I messed that up pretty bad. I should have been diving backwards, not to the side. So, yeah. Oh, well. And he'll actually show up later on, so it's not really too big of a deal that I lost right there. We just have a little bit more space to fight him in here. You get literally nothing for beating him, or nothing of great importance. You could get a pretty cool ring, but it'll only be an earlier ring than when you would get it in the actual game, so or the actual playthrough. So yeah, it's not too big of a deal. I mean, we're right next to him over here, so no big whoop, honestly. So let's go get our souls. I'm defeated. No big deal. And actually, I wouldn't say it's a beginner's trap, but it kind of sets up that there are things hunting you in this game. Sir, you are being hunted. Ah. Yeah. Sweet. And we got another firebomb. I don't think he's going to be here, but maybe he is. I don't know. No, guess not. Aw, that's a shame. I would like a second chance at him, but I guess not. We tried. We couldn't do it. Fail. He's not that difficult. You just have to know his patterns, and I apparently just messed it up. I was off by a little bit, and yep, you paid the price for it pretty severely. Okay. Let us switch to our slashy slash. This will help us deal with this little section a little bit easier, which is a room filled to the brim with traps. Oh, crap. And he was supposed to die. You were supposed to die, sir. Now you are not dead. Now I have to deal with all your slashy slashes. Ah. Take this. Yes. Take this. And that. All right. Yeah, you can get overwhelmed really easily with by those guys there. And actually, I don't have 4,000 souls to give, I don't think. But actually, maybe I do. Let's see. I need to go get that Pharaoh's key. Let's see. Okay, yeah, sweet. Awesome. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to go back up to that merchant, and we're going to buy that Pharaoh's lockstone. Now, in this game, there are various mechanisms that can be activated with the Pharaoh's lockstones. And they're pretty much these secretive areas that you can only unlock with these little doodads. And you'll find a bunch of them. And there's actually a covenant that gets them by default when you do something. I'll show you guys a little bit later. It's pretty damn awesome. This game's PvP is amazing. I love it. Speaking of PvP, everything is on a server now. Well, obviously everything's on a server, but it's like you both connect to a server, and the lag is not determined based on the host. It's based on it's just not based on the host. And I believe this is a trap. I'm pretty sure it's a trap. Yeah, gotta get out of here. Wah. There we go. Yeah. Titanite Shard, hooray. And here's where we use the Pharaoh's Lockstones. These little mouths here. And this will activate some faces on the walls. And you might be wondering, well, what the hell do these things do? And you just attack it. Like so. And you get access to some freaking awesome items. Oh, yes. One of them being the Chlorinthing Ring. Sometimes I get that little animation where it looks like I'm picking something up and it doesn't actually pick up. So the Chlorinthia ring is the exact same from Dark Souls. In fact, I think it even makes a mention to it. And a Titanite Slab, which you get a ton in this game, by the way. So the Chlorinthy ring is just the stamina booster, or the stamina regenerator. So, yeah, now we have some awesome stamina regeneration. And that will come in just absolute crazy handy, especially with our low endurance. Oh, yeah, it's over here. Okay. And let's go talk to Mr. Pate. Yes, 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 yes. So basically all he says is, I'm a searching treasure hunter, or I'm a traveling treasure hunter, and I would like you to go through here, but unfortunately the gate will close on you the instant that you go through. So, you know, if you want to go get some cool treasure, this gate will close. And he doesn't close on you, it just automatically does itself. So it's not like he's trying to kill you. So before we go there, we are going to go get some other stuff. And we can actually go on the backside of that area and take care of some guys from behind rather than take them all up front. And I think there's something behind here. Yes. Aha, sweet. Oh, by the way, if you ever see those explosive barrels next to walls, it's almost always a good idea to break them and try to make them explode. It may not be readily apparent right now, but yeah, just know that it is absolutely invaluable later on. Just crazy, crazy invaluable. Before I go take on those guys back there, I'm going to go over here first and finish Pate's little mission. Ah, take this. Look at this. Yeah, there we go. So back here, we can actually sneak up on these guys. When before, it would actually be, you have to go face them head on. And this would be like the ending area here. Okay, let's punch your shield. Or, that wasn't a punch. Ah, okay. I'm gonna cut you up. There we go. You actually have to take on a lot of these guys here. Just an absolute crap ton of them. But since we are here, get that. Ah, yeah. Boom. And we're not invincible when we're backstabbing, but it's pretty close. Yeah, there we go. You're pretty close to invincible. You just take a lot less damage, which is good. And did we get some more pants? Is that what? Oh, yeah, we got more pants. Or we got tall soldiers' leggings. I don't think we have any. Yeah, we don't have anything there. Okay, that's no big deal. So, oh, by the way, cloth physics. Yeah, these are awesome. Sucker. You try to trap me, I will trap you. Take this. Ouch. Ouch. Stop. 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 Take this. Alright, cool. Actually, this fire sword is pretty dang powerful. I'm pretty surprised by its actual power. I thought it would be weaker than the lightning sword, but it's not. So there's the closing the gate, which we triggered somehow by just being here. You know, video games. Makes sense. Actually, I'm not taking that much damage now that I'm thinking about it. So let me just throw on these. Because I'm doing really crappy with my stamina. And maybe this is just a little bit better. Yeah, now I can roll a little bit more. And that doesn't take up as much stamina anymore. So that's good. So that's a great benefit to leveling your vitality, is that you retain a hell of a lot more stamina. So that's cool. And I don't think we can jump to this side. No. And, okay, I was about to say, did I get myself stuck? No. Okay, sweet. Yes, and I managed to escape. I get the white soapstone. Sweet. And he basically tells you that he lost a friend in there, and he went somewhere, and he doesn't know where he is. And we'll solve that problem a little bit later. And I'm sorry, I was looking behind myself. Let's go get some of this stuff here. Now, the lightning sword is not bad. It's great for, like, single target damage, but this is much better for slicing and slashing. Obviously, because it has the wide swings. So yeah, let's go over here, jump here. And we're gonna plunge this guy. I'm gonna plunge a guy. Oh, I guess that didn't work out so well. Haha, take this. Take that, and this, and one of those. Oh, Jesus, no! Oh, I got parried! Holy crap, that's actually the first time I've ever been parried by one of these guys here. Ouch. Stop it. Knock it off. Quit it. Okay. Love the physics on the robe there. Let's open this up. Get the Mailbreaker and an infantry helmet. And I think that's substantially lighter than the holo helmet. Or maybe it's not. No, I guess it's the same. It's just more defensive. And we may pack on the defense for the first boss, but I guess we'll find out in just a second here. Okay, so I don't remember if this guy's weak to fire or what. Oh. Okay, let's try and get this guy into a favorable position. I think he's weak to lightning. Let's see. Oh, yeah. So anything that's like metal is way weaker to lightning. Damn it. Stop it. Stop your shenanigans. Take this. There we go. Yeah, and anything without armor is typically more damaged by fire. Just a rule of thumb there. Back here's an item. And that's okay. Some homeward bizones. And slice them up. Oh, okay, never mind. I don't want to slice them up. Now I want to slice them up. Ouch. Okay, and I'm just getting my butt kicked because I'm not taking my time. Ouch. Ouch. Stop. Stop. Alright, let's do the punch. Okay, never mind. Don't do the punch. There we go. Now do the riposte. Yeah, that's new in the game right there. Which is so awesome. It's easily one of the coolest things ever. If you can actually hit a guy whose shield is up, you'll go into a repostable animation, which just does tons of damage. It's not as much damage as a backstab, I think, but it does do a bunch. And it's not as much damage as a riposte itself. So let's trigger this guy and then run back, because we're going to get trapped. We don't want to do that. Let's punch this guy. Okay. That guy does not want me to kill his friend. Ouch. Not very nice of you. Take this. Alright, let's heal up. We're actually pretty close to a bonfire. Is he still shielded? Stop shielding. I hate you. Now die. There we go. Ah, beautiful scenery. This game is absolutely gorgeous. Like I mentioned before, it's stunning to me that this is actually a game on what is now considered a old gen console. I mean, it's absolutely gorgeous. Everything about it is just amazing. All right, and let's see. I know there's a lizard right there, but which thing actually attacks downwards? Okay, that attacks downwards. All right, so let's kill this guy. Aha! Oh no! No! Stop it! Take this! Kill you both! Yeah! 2 Titanite shards. Cool. We can upgrade our weapon even more. Hooray! And it's always a good idea to level up your weapon pretty much as high as it can go, if you can help it, because it'll help you way more than levels will. That's another kind of rule of thumb of Dark Souls. Fire arrows. I believe this guy is weak to fire. But we have to go refill our Estus Flask before we do that. And before we do that, let's kill these guys again. Get some more souls, and we can go level up our weapon. Actually, we may need some health. That might be a thing that we have to do. Actually, let's go fight him first, and then we'll determine that after we are done fighting him. All right, so first of all, get this. Cool. And, I meant to not do that. Let's go back to Majula. And we can go level up some more. And I'm so excited to get another monitor. This is going to be awesome. 27 inches. I had to upgrade myself. It's been about 5 years or so. And, yeah, it's going to be pretty cool. Oh, hello, Uber Kitten. That's actually a person I PvP'd with when I tried my Castlevania build. My Castlevania build being dual whips, which is just so much fun. It's amazing. Okay. So you. Let's reinforce, and we'll try to keep these about even. Actually, for right now, I think it'd be better to level up the fire sword since the next boss is weak to fire. And then the next boss after that is weak to lightning, so...
Yep.
I'm a master of deciding things. There we go. I'm not going to do one thing. I am going to do one thing. Yep. Okay. And yes, I will do that. I will get some more stuff. Yes, thank you very much. Yes. That's the only reason why it's just like... You have to wait for her to talk to you. Alright. Get some more life up in this. And each time you die, actually, if you notice at the top right there, I know my directions, the top left, you can actually see that your health actually gets lower per death. And it's not too much of a problem when you first start out, but eventually it gets to be a pretty large detriment, especially when you're fighting guys who can basically one-shot you at, you know, around 1,500 health. You want to make sure that you have pretty high health. I ended up with 50 vitality. So same thing as Dark Souls before, 50 vitality seems to be the ideal spot to aim for. So I had about 30 endurance. I had a lot of the equipment load stuff. So I could roll more effectively with super heavy armor. And since you can do it at 70%, you have a much better chance of dodging things even when you're in full armor. Excuse me. Phew. I'm just talking. Everyone is talking at me. Ouch. Alright. And the only reason I'm killing these guys is eventually they're going to get pretty frustrating. One of them will try to follow you everywhere, so I just want to make sure that he's... If I can get the respawn counter to go down to zero, that would be helpful. Even though it doesn't really matter. Alright. We'll get in that fire area. Don't worry about that. But that won't happen for a while. Okay, so let's kill this guy here. Okay. And this door is locked for now. And that actually leads into that fire area, so wonderful. Okay, so here's the first boss. Oh, fun. Let's watch it. Yeah, this guy's pretty scary with like a giant hole in his face. But actually you'll find out that this is what pretty much all the giants look like anyway. Okay, the one thing you want to do is make absolutely sure that you dodge that foot and his hands right there. Okay, let's back up a bit. And make sure I don't get hit. Okay, cool. Make sure I do not get hit. That stupid foot, because that foot can actually hurt you really bad. Ouch. And even his hands can hurt too, I guess. Eventually, he will actually escalate the battle, and he will start taking off his hands, or he'll take off one of his arms and start doing battle like that. That's an ideal time to attack. Okay. Let's dodge out of the way there. Keep on dodging. And he's dead. Alright, cool. And that is the first... Yeah, he's like holding his own arm. It's awesome. Alright, so not too bad. Not too bad of a boss. I actually did struggle with him, like, originally. But after I learned his moveset, he actually becomes pretty simple. He's no big deal. Now, the rest of the bosses, I'm not so sure. They get pretty damn difficult pretty damn fast. So, yeah. Like, for instance, the very next boss to this is actually Pursuer. Oh, yeah. He does exist. He does exist, indeed. So actually, yeah, let's use our souls because this is quite a bit of souls. I don't want them to go away, so yeah. I think we have a pretty good shot against Pursuer. I mean, we almost got him down to about half health, before I was sort of dumbly rolling. But, that's basically his moveset. There's nothing really different from that moveset that you saw. He charges you if you're far away, he stabs you if you're close, it's... yeah. Yeah. Alright. Okay, so let's level up our weapon if we can. That would be ideal.
Aye.
And this time we want to start leveling up our lightning weapon, so what do we need? We need 3 Titanite Shards. Let's see, how much do those cost? 800 piece. We can need 6 of them. Yes, and then we can level up both of our weapons to level 3. So let's do that. Okay, perfect. And let's go over here and level up again. And as you can see, the person in the background there, that's actually our merchant girl. And she'll sell us some good stuff. Okay. So let's just keep on cranking our vigor. We're gonna need it. We are gonna need it. And the rule of thumb is that if you don't know what stat to put into, it's almost always a good idea to put into vigor. Same goes for all the other Souls games. The best stat you can possibly donate to is vitality if you don't know what you're doing. Just to be sure that you don't die. I mean, it's preferable to not die. Because you can stay alive and do as much damage as you want with just, like, chip damage, but it's just going to take you a little bit longer. You're not going to do as much damage, but at the end of the day, like, it's dodge rolling and taking the hits, taking those, like, brutal hits that you want to survive. That will allow you to continue longer. So whereas you maybe have missed a critical dodge, well, now you can take more hits. Yeah. At least that's my thinking, my thought process. Okay, and same thing as before. We're just going to take out these guys. Let's farm for a little bit of soulage. Cool stuff. And now we're doing substantially more damage. Not because we're leveling up, but because we are leveling up our weapons. It is critical to upgrade your weapons first. So, and then we're going to fight these two goons right here. Okay, and let's make sure that we do not get overwhelmed. Oh. Ouch. Okay, that's not very nice of you guys. Stop it. Okay, that guy's gonna die here soon. These guys are actually pretty tough to begin with, but they get a lot easier later on. So, if you're having trouble with them now, eventually you'll reach a point where you can get them pretty easily. Okay, so we're rocking and rolling. We have about, I'd say about 5 minutes left or so. Let's see if we can kill this pursuer guy. This pursuit. Pursuers. Ouch. Ouch. It's not very nice. And there's a guy behind us who's trying to hit us too. It's not very nice either. And I can actually buy an infinite amount of life gems from that merchant girl. So if you're really struggling for some health, you can grind a bit and just go right back to her and buy some more gems. At least that's what I would do anyway. I usually buy, later on in the game, I'll buy like 50 at a time. Because they're super, super useful. And we just got more, so don't be afraid to use your life gems. They're replenishable very easily, so. Alright, let's face the big old jerk. Because he's a big old jerk. You can see all the weapons on his back from all these slain undead. Alright, let's see if we can take this fool down. Alright, I want you to charge me. There we go. Oh yeah, doing a lot more damage to him now. No big deal. We can slice him up. Okay, let's just take it easy on our stamina drain here, as we don't want to get too greedy. We can actually do another tactic of shooting these little ballistas, but I've never, ever gotten it to work. He sort of just destroys them immediately, which I don't really like. Yeah, man. No. You stay away from me. All right, you charge me now. Alright, oh, I didn't mean to do that. Okay. Let's heal up here. No big deal. Epic battle music. Okay. Oh. Stay away from that move there, by all costs. If you do not, you will have a very, very bad day. Come on, charge man. There you go. So you can see that this guy is fairly predictable. He's not too bad. Oh, just duck away from that as quickly as you can. Do not risk it and try to take that on. He will curse you. It's not very nice. Okay. And this should be the end of him right here. Oh, I guess not. Oh. Let's try not to die one time. Let's heal up. Oop. Okay, now he's dead. All right, sweet. We got the Pursuer, got the Lost Giant, and yeah, it should be pretty good. Yeah, the first time I took that guy on, by the way, don't feel bad if you die to that guy, because he is actually very difficult. If you don't know what he does. But if you get stabbed by that move, yeah, you're gonna... Oh, there's nothing over here. You're gonna feel the pain, and he's gonna start using new moves and just totally wreck your shit, and it's not gonna be fun. Alright, so let's drop down here, and we're gonna get our 100% block shield, which is the Drangleic shield. And the Drangleic sword as well, but we're not gonna really use that, so it's not too big of a problem. But and also the Drangleic armor is probably one of the first, I think it is the first heavy armor set that you get in the game. So that's kind of cool. All right, so we have won, guys. Sweet. I think that's pretty good for that episode, so let's just carry on to the next. All right, guys, talk to you in the next episode. See ya!